I spent a lot of time with her, and the social worker, I called Sandy, the social worker at the cancer agency, for help, and she helped with, you know, talking to her, counseling her, telling her it's okay to cry, and it was, then I talked to the doctor, her own family doctor, and eventually we managed to get her on antidepressants, and that, it took her out of it. It really helped her a lot after that, but it was a whole good 2 months of struggle. It was a struggle because she was not, she's never been independent, and she's never done anything away from, you know, on her own. She's always been with my dad. If they went out, it was dad and my mom. They went out, had coffee, they shopped, they did everything together. So suddenly he was gone and she had no idea what to do. She didn't even know how to turn on the washing machine because he did everything. So it was really scary for her. It was a struggle. After my dad passed away, my mom had a really, really difficult time. When we were planning his funeral, she could not even think about it. She resisted everything that we said. She just didn't want certain things. She changed her mind. She wanted a certain color of certain things, and then she wanted something else. So it was, every day was different, and it was actually very, very difficult for myself and my brother to deal with. My mom had all these other traditions, you know, especially during the ceremony or the service, and how things should be done, and things that we had no idea what these were and how these came about, and is it really tradition, or is it hearsay, or is it, I don't know. We struggled with that too, my brother and I, who were trying to get the service ready and prepare for it. And she wanted certain colors, she wanted the blanket, she wanted this, and certain pallbearers and certain traditions she said had to be done. And none of us knew anything about it because it has never been talked about. There were many times when we actually had really heated discussions because she was not about what was going to happen. And so we had to say, this is not what Dad would have wanted. She wanted to spend more. And we had to say, no, this is the limit. This is what he wanted. She wanted, there were just things. It's really actually hard to explain, even to describe what was going on. And we actually had to talk to other people, talk to her nieces and say, can you actually explain to her, this is how we need to do things. We're not trying to do anything against her wishes, because we wanted to make her feel happy too, that she's getting something that she wanted for my dad. But when it's beyond what's realistic and what's possible, then it was just trying to find a way to convince her, this is what it should be, and we need to follow this, and do you understand what's going on? But she wasn't at that point ready to listen. She now, when she reflects back, she even says she wasn't in the right frame of mind. She was not really thinking.